Hey Star Wars fans, another action figure review for you here. This one is for R2-D2 from the Vintage Collection. He isn't even out yet in shops. He isn't even out in the wave to buy yet, but it is online on a couple of stores out there. And I managed to get it, and we'll give you a little usual HD review that we normally do and go around the entire figure. You would not believe the amount of extras that this figure has. Just to give you a quick display with the older R2. This is the older one here with the vac metalized dome. We're looking quite different figures, and again, the extras make for quite an interesting review. So, old one aside, let's get a closer zoom in of this guy and we'll talk about some of the features he has. So as I said, R2-D2 from the Vintage Collection, it's coming out very soon as part of one of the new waves. How the seller managed to get this online, I do not know, but nice to see this R2. So loads of features again, as I mentioned, to talk about. I'll give you just a look overall at the figure without going into the detail of the extras just now. You can see there's a panel on the front, I'll talk about that as well. But the detail is particularly good. Paintwork, excellent. Thank you, Hasbro. You've done a good job in applying the paint, or whoever it was that's doing it. All over, it's pretty much as you would expect R2 to be. I don't know whether the difference of having the dome vac metalized or not makes a huge difference to me. I'm not quite sure what I love yet, but. Somewhere in between would be nice, but it's still a great looking figure. So there we go, that's a quick round of R2. Now, one of the biggest aspects, let's get the front out of the way. I'll open the panel that's on the front, which is a little tricky to open. But once you do get it open, you'll see inside, there we go. This is what you get. You get R2's arm, which appears in several clips. I think it's the Empire Strikes Back, maybe I'm wrong. But even the attachment that he comes out with there is pretty detailed. It could be anything. So that's that. That's one function out of the way. Oops, don't try and close it like I did without putting the device back in. So it sits inside. And that clips over. So fairly hard to get out, but it, once you do, it's not too bad. And sits in quite flush with the body. Seems to be a lighter paint job on that compartment there is the one above in the blue, which I guess detracts from it a little bit. We're really picking holes in it here. So the third leg is, I believe, not detachable. I may be wrong. Let me just see if I'm going to break this figure or not. Yep, it's not detachable because, that's right, I completely forgot. The leg itself goes up. So if I put the two figures down, you'll watch what happens when I put this up. Up comes a sensor scope. So you may be thinking, well, what if I don't want the sensor scope? Does that mean I'm stuck? No, all you need to do is take this component out. I'll have a look, I'll show you this first of all. So the sensor scope, which you see again in Empire Strikes Back in Dagobah, and I think on Hoth as they shut the doors at night. So it's shaped like the wedge of R2's dome. And what you get to see inside, let me see if we can just align that a little better. There's a small compartment and piece you would press down. Now there is a hole at the very top of R2's head, which is for something else I'll show you in a minute, but that leaves this hole and this slot that's in there. What Hasbro do is, rather coolly, because this is from the Return of the Jedi wave, is give you one other extra, which is Luke's lightsaber. Try and do my best to show you that. Nicely detailed, accurate looking Return of the Jedi Luke Skywalker lightsaber. Going to be even more important for that scene that we've all seen from Celebration 5, where Luke actually inserts this into the droid itself. So that can be inserted inside of R2's headpiece. And if we push that down, I think it goes in anyway. Yep, you can. You can have the lightsaber completely inside the dome with the leg down, and if you push the leg up, hopefully it won't go flying everywhere. I'll try and catch it. you go. I guess you can have a kind of action mechanism where the leg pushes up and the lightsaber comes flying at the top. So that's one use for that aspect in there. You can have neither that or the sensor scope and just have, if you turn, I'll try and capture this on camera, as we can see, there's the white hole piece there, and as I turn, you can have just a standard blue. So it doesn't pop up, but it looks and gives you some kind of continuity for the figure, so you can kind of mask off that aspect if you don't want that on your figure. So you think I might be done by this point on some of the extras we have for this figure, but we're far from it. Again, Return of the Jedi wave. So this guy comes with drinks aspect. I always call this when the drinks are on me, R2, because the drinks truly are on this guy, and that is that comes with this other attachment, the small drink or cup holder, which goes into that hole we talked about in R2's head, which is just vacant, there's nothing there at all. So again, just to show you, the hole right in the very center is where this guy goes. Let me just pop that in there, just fits in, and you'll see there's a small piece that then sits on the top of R2's dome. Well, it does if you push it hard enough, and you can then, I believe, push that into. Sorry, we're doing this live, guys. No, it doesn't. I thought it would maybe go into the hole that was in R2's head, but it doesn't. But there you go. You can twist it, and there we go. We have the drinks on me, R2-D2. So not only that is the one of the attachments that R2 comes with, but it also comes with the drinks tree from Return of the Jedi. This gold ornate, very detailed from Hasbro piece. Now, all of those cups may look a little odd, they're actually removable pieces as well. I kind of freaked out when I got this figure. The amount of attachments we have and things that come with R2, that makes it a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 12, 12 things which come with R2-D2. So, yeah, certainly not skimping on this from Hasbro. Nice to see it. So there's the drinks cabinet. These sit on a little fairly crooked, but they do all come off. But once they're on, it's fairly hard to remove them. Let me try and remove one just to show you. Oh, it's actually easier than I thought. And you'll see a small wedge there. Let me get back around to you where the cup goes. And the cup has a small circular piece, and that sits on the top. Hopefully these all won't fall off together. There we go. And once the wedge done, so that makes a stand. My stand came a little splayed out, and the best thing you can do is grab one of those small pieces of a plastic which comes with a figure, a small piece normally wrapped around the hand to hold blasters and lightsabers on, and place that around the casing once it's over R2, and that'll keep that in place a little bit, and it's practically invisible. You can't see that at all. So let me put this onto R2 with these drinks cabinet, and mine's sitting on fairly well. Well, it was. It'll sit on his shoulders, and there's a small piece at the back of the head which holds it on. As you can see, the plastic does come away and bends it a little. I've only just got this out of the packet. Well, the packaging, this didn't come with a card back, it was loose. And the figure tended to be a little splayed in the packet, but you can fix that easily with that small plastic clip. So there you go, R2-D2 from the vintage collection. I haven't seen anybody talk about this, so it's really new, really hot off the press. And hopefully we'll get to see some other figures from the vintage collection, this new Return of the Jedi wave real soon. It's a great looking wave. There's a Gamorrean guard, Admiral Akbar, Luke Skywalker, and quite a few others. You'll see images for that wave on our Picasa high-res images page if you want to go there and have a drool like me. Huge images, about 1,000 pixels each, with no branding on them. You can do what you want with them. They're straight from Hasbro, straight to you guys. So do what you want. So that's R2-D2. I managed to pick this up for, if I didn't say, a ridiculously cheap price on eBay with another astromech which we reviewed earlier on, R4P17. The actual unit itself, the astromech R2, was at $6. That's Australian, which is exactly the same as US dollars currently. And even with shipping, it made the entire package only $10. And that even allowed me to get some other figures there. So go online and get one of these if you want one. Saving you the packaging, although a lot of you probably want R2-D2 for the vintage packaging, but I'll forgo, I'm not a huge carded collector. But there we go, so another figure out there in the one nice and early from the vintage collection. And yeah, leave us a comment, tell us what you think. Join us on Facebook, some good stuff going on there, and or leave a comment after this video and subscribe, and you'll get more videos from us real soon. See you shortly.